Dear students, welcome to my YouTube channel English Mania. Today's video is about the lesson 4.3 Around the World in 80 Days, written by Jules Gabriel Verne. So let's see a brief introduction of the writer. So Jules Gabriel Verne is a French novelist, poet, and playwright. He wrote widely popular series of adventure novels, including Journey to the Center of the Earth, which was published in 1864. Then he wrote 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. It was published in 1870. And Around the World in 80 Days is also an adventure novel, which was published in 1873. And Verne is generally considered a major literary author in France and most of Europe. And let me tell you very interesting fact that Verne has been the second most translated author in the world. So Around the World in 80 Days has four major characters: the protagonist Phileas Fogg, Passepartout, Aouda, and Detective Fix. There are 10 minor characters: Sir Francis Cromarty, John Burnby, the Reform Club members, the Parsi guide, Colonel Stamp Proctor, Mr. Camerfield, Mr. Mandyboy, Elder William H. Mudge, and last one is Captain Speedy. So there are many movie adaptations, but the famous one was Around the World in 80 Days, released in 2004, where Jackie Chan was the hero. Now let's see plot summary of the novel. So Around the World 80 Days begins at the Reform Club in England with Phileas Fogg, Thomas Flanagan, Samuel Fallentin, and John Sullivan sitting by a fireplace reading newspapers. And we are introduced to Fogg, a very precise man who regularly goes to the Reform Club every evening. And at the Reform Club, Fogg, Flanagan, Fallentin, and Sullivan are talking about a recent bank robbery. This conversation leads to a wager. Wager means bet. Fogg is quite sure he can travel around the world in 80 days, while Sullivan doesn't believe it can be done. Then Sullivan, Flanagan, and Fallentin think Fogg is not considering the unexpected all of the men except the wager for £20,000. And this is the beginning of the entire plot. And from then on, we see how Fogg goes around the world and we witness the amazing adventures that he has with his companions. The main plot is based on Fogg's travels, while other such plots merely support the central theme. Let's see Fogg's character. So Phileas Fogg is a rich British gentleman living in solitude. Despite his wealth, Fogg lives a modest life with habits carried out with mathematical precision. Very little can be said about his social other than that he is a member of the Reform Club, as we have already seen, where he spends much of every day. Having dismissed his former valet, James Foster, for bringing him shaving water at 84 degrees instead of 86, so Fogg hires Frenchman Jean Passepartout as a replacement. So we see in the novel, with Passepartout accompanying Fogg, they depart from London by train at 8:45 on 2nd October in order to win the wager, and he must return to the club by this same time on 21st December, 80 days later. They take the remaining £20,000 of Fogg's fortune with them to cover expenses during the journey. Now we see the introduction of Detective Fix. Fogg and Passepartout reach Suez in time. While disembarking in Egypt, they are watched by a Scotland Yard detective, Detective Fix, who has been dispatched from London in search of a bank robber. Detective Fix mistakes Fogg for the criminal. Then comes the character of Aouda, After reaching India, they take a train from Bombay to Calcutta. They come across a procession in which a young Indian woman, Auda, is to undergo sati. Since she is drugged with opium and hemp and is obviously not going voluntarily, the travelers decide to rescue her. They follow the procession to the site where Passepartout takes the place of Auda's deceased husband on the funeral pyre. During the ceremony, he rises from the pyre, scaring off the priest and carries Auda away. The 12 hours gained earlier are lost, but Fox shows no regret. Fox's destination is Liverpool. Fox goes through Bombay, now called Mumbai, Calcutta, now called Kolkata, Hong Kong, Yokohama, San Francisco, New York, and Liverpool. Now we witness the climax of the novel. So as soon as Fogg, Auda, and Passepartout arrive in Liverpool, as I have just told you, Liverpool is Fogg's destination. So Fix produces a warrant and arrests Fogg. A short time later, the misunderstanding is cleared up. The actual robber, an individual named James Strand, had been caught 3 days earlier in Edinburgh. However, Fogg has missed the train and arrives in London 5 minutes late, certain he has lost the wager. The following day, Fogg apologizes to Auda for bringing her with him. Since he now has to live in poverty and cannot support her, Auda confesses that she loves him and asks him to marry her. As Passepartout notifies a clergyman to arrange their marriage, he learns that he is mistaken in the date. It's not 22nd December, but instead 21st December. Because the party had traveled eastward, the travel had gained them a day. So I explain you what exactly happened. When they traveled eastward, their days were shortened by 4 minutes for each of the 360 degrees of longitude they crossed. Thus, although they had experienced the same amount of time abroad as people had experienced in London, they had seen only 79. So, Passepartout informs Fogg of his mistake, and Fogg hurries to the Reform Club just in time to meet his deadline and wins the wager. And finally, Phileas Fogg wins the bet. He is rich once more, but more important, as he says to himself, he has won the heart of a charming woman. So let me show you the plot outline of the novel. So we see exposition in the plot, then climax, then falling action, and finally we have resolution. What happened first is Fogg is challenged to go around the world in 80 days. He accepts the challenge and prepares to travel with his butler and £20,000. Then Fogg faces several obstacles. The railway in Calcutta is incomplete. He misses a boat because he has not been informed. And in America, outlaws attack his train and take away his butler, Passepartout. Then Fogg is followed by Detective Fix, who thinks that Fogg is a bank robber and tries to retain him in India to arrest him. He does well. They land in Liverpool, their destination. Then the real robber is caught, but Fogg thinks he has arrived in London 5 minutes late. He is disappointed and goes back to his residence. Now, when making arrangements to marry Auda, Fogg gets to know that he has indeed saved time and arrives at the Reform Club at precisely 8:45. "Here I am, gentlemen," he says and wins the bet. Then falling action. Fogg has won the bet, though he had won the £20,000 since he had spent some £19,000 on the way. The proceeds were small. Now, the resolution. Although Fogg doesn't get much from his winning, he marries Auda, a charming woman who makes him the happiest of men. Now let's see the themes of the novel. First important theme is perseverance and determination is the best motivation towards success. So let me elaborate this point. As you know, Phileas Fogg is very determined, who always put in great effort of anything he does. His determination leads him to accept a bet to travel around the world in 80 days. Fogg shows his perseverance and determination throughout the novel by finishing what he has started, and no matter how difficult the obstacle is, he always gives his best efforts and overcomes the difficulty. Second important theme of the novel is one must be strong in mind and spirit so as to be able to face any adversities. Like Fogg is a disciplined man and he is always punctual. Third important theme is to remain true to one's course in life. So it is important to remain true to one's course in life. Like we have already seen, Fogg together with Passepartout and Auda have only one mission, that is to reach London before the 80 days are over. However, when they arrive, they think they have missed the boat by 5 minutes. But Fogg is able to accept the fact that he has lost not only the boat but also his money. So he is a true gentleman. Next important theme is generosity. So as we have already seen in the novel, Fogg is very generous throughout the trip. He compensates more than enough money to a captain of a boat so that they can use the wood as fuel for their trip. So when the situations arise, he is willing to pay nearly anything in order to overcome the obstacle. Fifth important theme of the novel is time is precious and time should be used in the most practical manner if once lost cannot be regained. Seventh important theme is life's lessons must be faced with patience and strength. And last one is challenges and struggles are part of life. So these are some important themes of the novel we have seen so far. Thank you so much for watching this video. In the next video, I will explain the activity-based questions on this particular novel, Around the World in 80 Days. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.